When you were doing your early solo albums, you know that one you did in Scotland that you recorded yourself?
Well, it was in London actually, but McCartney, yeah.
Oh, the Cherry Tunnel.
Yeah. Just doing it in the living room with a four track. Going straight into the back.
Didn't you do one in Scotland?
Well, I got a little studio in Scotland called Rude where I've done similar stuff.
Right.
So that particular one was in when Linda and I first got together. It was called McCartney.
Yeah.
Fabulous album, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, people at the moment seem to be referencing that album as a strong influence.
Yeah.
And that's got a
good way. It fits with the mood of the moment.
Yeah,
that kind of thing. You know, it's a little bit, it's a little bit striking a blow for freedom. So that's what I was doing at the time. It was the end of the Beatles, you know, we had these management problems.
Right.
I was like just fed up with it. So I ended up just, I thought, well, I'll just make some music and try and escape that way.
It's got a sort of nakedness.
Yeah, but it was the same kind of thing we did with Firewood, you know, it was made up on the spot, most of it. A couple of pieces were actually written, and made me amazed. I think, was that all right?
Did you, not Band on the Run and stuff, did you have that written before you went on to
Africa?
That was actually a concept. Was the songs actually tied?
Yeah, kind of. It was during the era when, you know, everyone was like desperados.
Yeah.
And people were getting busted left, right, and centre and things.
Yeah.
So the spirit was like, you know, we're all in this together.
Yeah.
So anything like about desperados or
right.
on the run or
yeah.
kind of united people against the authority, I suppose. And you know, we happen to be part of that. And, so I got this idea of, you reckon we're done?
We've got enough,
you know, we've got enough stuff.
For
now, great.